If A is a symmetric matrix, we can find an orthogonal diagonalization. And if A is square, we can sometimes find a diagonalization or else a Jordan form. But what can we do if A is not even square? In that case, we have the so-called singular value decomposition, as you will see in this video. So, if we have a symmetric A, we can write A as A equals P times D times P transpose with some nice orthogonal matrix P. If A is not symmetric but still square, we may be able to write A as A equals P times D times P inverse. So, what are we going to do if A is not a square matrix? Say A is an M times N matrix. In that case, we can write A as U times sigma times V transpose, where the U and the V are still nice matrices. U is an orthogonal matrix, an M times M orthogonal matrix, and V is also an orthogonal matrix, an N times N orthogonal matrix. So V transpose is also an N times N orthogonal matrix. And this matrix sigma in between contains the rubbish. Sort of rubbish. Sigma is sort of a diagonal matrix. Not a square matrix, so not a real diagonal matrix, but an M times N matrix, which contains a lot of zeros. So, let's see an example. How does that look? If we have this 3 by 2 matrix A, for example, over here, then we can write A as U times sigma times V transpose. We will learn later how to find U, sigma and V in here. I just give them. So here we have our U, so that will become a 3 by 3 matrix, an orthogonal matrix. Our V will be a 2 by 2 matrix in this case, also orthogonal. And then our sigma will contain some of the rubbish. Sigma will not be a square matrix, but sigma will be a 3 by 2 matrix like this. Well, if you want to check whether this is indeed true, A equals U times sigma times V transpose, you usually put the V transpose on the other side. Well, why is that? Then you get A times V transpose inverse, and it has to be equal to U times sigma. But V is an orthogonal matrix, so V transpose equals V inverse. So V transpose inverse is just equal to the V. So if you want to check whether your decomposition is indeed correct, you usually compute A times V and U times sigma. So let's do that in this case. Here we have A, and here we have our V. So just use row-column rule, for example. So the 1 together with the 1 over square root of 2, 1 over square root of 2 gives you a 2 over square root of 2 over here. And in the same way, you can compute all the other elements. And similarly, you compute your U times sigma. Also, you can use the row-column rule. So make a bunch of rows and here a bunch of columns. And then you get 2 over square root of 6 times square root of 3 equals 2 over square root of 2 plus 0 plus 0. So that's your first element over here. And similarly, you can compute all the other ones. And then indeed, you see that your A times V yields the same as your U times sigma. So in this case, if you have already given your decomposition, you can check whether that is indeed correct decomposition. Question remains, why do we want to do this, of course, and how do you find such a decomposition? And that will be the subject of consecutive videos.